Yes. Be strong in the Lord.
Won't forget about y'all.
Of his might.
Put on the whole armor. Anybody know what's up with Ephesians chapter 6?
Against the wiles
of the devil. Armor up.
Armor up.
Yeah.
Just think of your battle gear and armor up.
Why? Many are called, but the chosen are few. The enemy is tyrant, so what you gonna do? Armor up. Now armor up. Just pick up your battle gear and armor up. Many are called, but the chosen are few. The enemy is tyrant, so what you gonna do? It's here to give a message from the Father above, to spread a bit of awareness for the ones that he loves. I've been given direct orders, but brief me with this detail. This is for intelligence, if I put it in a nutshell. The first point I want to make is verse 11. From Ephesians chapter 6, it's coming straight out of heaven. And it tells us on the back about PID, y'all. Positive identification of enemy. The next verse is a real self-check. Look at yourself in the mirror real quick. The two eyes in your head can't even see what's happening. But we wrestle not against flesh and blood in this battle. Principalities and powers and the rulers of the dark of this world here. Now that's real talk. We got spiritual wickedness. Very high places. Causing us problems and putting anguish on our places. But that's why I'm taking you into verse 13. Because instructions are in place for the victory team. You got to take unto you the whole armor of God. That you might be able to withstand when times get hard. Stand therefore, cut your loins with the truth. The breastplate of righteousness is the key to your battle suit. Your feet should be shod with the gospel of peace. If you feel what I'm saying, grab your Bibles, follow me.
Armor up, armor up. Your battle gear and armor up.
Many are called, but the chosen are few. The enemy is tyrant, so what you wanna do? Armor up,
armor up.
Battle gear and armor up. Many are called, but the chosen are few. The enemy is firing, so what you gonna do? I'm gonna finalize your learning to the sound of piano keys. Verse 16 speaks about this enemy. It starts with above all, which is really valuable, because it means most importantly. Now that you really know, let me tell you something about these fiery thoughts. There's a shield called faith that makes them all real soft. Now if you use this shield, speak it into your lives, y'all. The Father steps in, makes it all real tight, y'all. The helmet of salvation is the key to your thoughts. Protection from the wicked and his fiery thoughts. The sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. It finalizes verse 17 for us all. As we implement the plan that he has for this battle, I'm riding his word like I was sitting on a saddle. Pray always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, because in our flesh we're all abominations. Watching thereunto with all perseverance. Supplication for all saints, so the Father can hear it. He sees what you're going through. He knows what you're thinking. He'll deliver you from it all if you would just breathe. So think about the orders that he's putting on your spirit. Armor up with his word. Render the devil incoherent. I gotta send the message. He needs your attention. For the Father's in the midst of your struggles and he listens. But you gotta help yourself. Get on your knees. Use every bit of faith that you have. And please keep reading. Let him do his thing. You will find that it's easy. The battle is not yours. The win is a guarantee. He gave you your body armor. He shoots your rifle. All kinds of ammo. Don't let it stay idle. Get through the fire and range and stay real accurate. All that is Bible study. Look at it. Keeps me on point. But that's why he chose me. Because I've been to combat. He showed it to me. I've been trained to accomplish missions with devastating kills. Holy Spirit in me is the main reason I know. I thank the Father for you. I thank God for your time. And allowing me to brief you in the form of a rhyme. Keep your weapon at the ready. Open your eyes. That enemy will back off and you'll see his disguise is dismissed. It's important. Paul goes on to say, as for me,
and for me,
that utterance may be given unto me, that I might open my mouth boldly and speak the word of the gospel.
Of the gospel.
For which I am an ambassador in bonds.
For which I am an ambassador in bonds.
That therein, meaning there in the word,
I may speak
boldly as I ought to speak.
As
so everybody old Crenshaw can hear it. He goes on to say, peace with love to those who love the Lord Jesus Christ in sincerity. Grace be with all them who love the Lord Jesus Christ with all of their heart. That's y'all. Amen. Okay.